The North-South Metro line in Amsterdam is one of the most challenging infrastructure projects in Dutch history.
City center was fully congested. We expected more congestion in the long run. There were too many cars, so we had to improve public transport. It's not enough just to add a few buses to it, but we had to add other means of transport like this North-South line metro line.
The North-South line is a metro line of 9.1 kilometers, of which 7.1 is underground. The preconditions for building this connection were to cause no damage to the historical character of Amsterdam city center and to minimize the disruption of daily life. The technical challenges were enormous. Amsterdam's first 11 meters of soil consists of layers of peat and soft clay. The soil is saturated with water. The city is built on wooden piles, finding stable ground on a deeper layer of sand. Due to the soil condition, earlier plans to realize the North-South line had to be postponed. Tunnel Engineering Consultants, TEC, managed to find a way to resurrect the project. Hans de Witt and Frank Kalberg worked together to find solutions for the challenges.
To minimize the impact that the construction of the metro line could have on the historic environment of the city of Amsterdam, we selected an alignment that was following the street patterns as closely as possible.
The North-South line is built at about 25 meters below the surface. New bored tunnel techniques had to be applied because of the unique soil conditions in this project.
The tunnel boring machines used for this project were very special. They have been designed together with the contractor and the TBM manufacturer because they had to deal with very tight radiuses through the city because we have to follow the street pattern, and they also have to deal with soft soil, sticky clay, and even the concrete walls at the end of the station boxes.
Another assignment was crossing the Eye River to make the connection with the northern part of the city. Until then, it was only possible to cross the Eye River by boat.
The Meurs tunnel technique was used to cross the Eye River. Pretty special in international tunneling, but not uncommon for Amsterdam since the Dutch are considered one of the pioneers in the Meurs tunneling. The real challenge was crossing or underpassing the central station.
A delicate operation considering the fact the railway station is listed as a monument. While daily train services in one of the busiest locations in Amsterdam continued, a partial new foundation was installed below the station using a so-called table structure. Underneath, an artificial canal was made.
Once the table structure was completed, the tunnel element could be taken in and to immerse it into position. But you should imagine that the overarching structures there were on surface level, so there was a very limited headroom, which made the operation quite challenging, the immersion operation. And once it was immersed into position, which was done in approximately a day, the entrance at the north side of the station could be constructed.
Building underground in a historic city center is delicate. Every millimeter potential subsidence counts. The world's largest monitoring program was specially developed for this project. Beamed light signals of 90 robotic total stations were reflected via 4,500 prisms at the facades of the buildings, and approximately another 5,000 reflectorless readings at the surface. It provided real-time information about potential subsidences.
All this data was online available for the TBM process operators to adjust their process control parameters, like, for example, the pressure at the front and the pressure at the back of the machine.
In order to maintain delicate buildings at their position during boring and construction works, the TEC engineers implemented another new technique in the weak soil of the Netherlands, compensation grouting.
compensation grouting is basically a technique where you install an array of injection tubes under the piles, under the pile toes, and when the tunnel boring machine passes and creates settlements, you're able to inject grout, which is a mixture of sand and cement, and then you're able to pump up the building.
The north-south line contains 5 underground stations. TEC chose a sturdy construction design with diaphragm walls. Special precautions were taken to limit the impact on surrounding buildings.
The diaphragm walls, they were massive walls, but because the station was so deep, 26 meters, it had to be supported on various levels to make sure that the deformations of the wall were very small in order to protect the building sufficiently. And an ultimate measure was that we, before the excavation even took place, the deep jet grout strut was installed from surface level, and that was a concrete layer that is mixed in with the soil and gives you a very solid strut below the excavation level.
At this location, we walk right on top of station De Pijp. At this station, the facades are very close to each other, so it wasn't possible to design a center platform in the middle of the street. So in the end, we decided to have the two tunnel tubes right above each other, and they are entering the station box right at this location.
In order to enter the station on 2 levels, the tunnel tubes had to be bored separately for the 16-meter-wide Ferdinand Ballstraat.
We found out that the challenges were very huge. So that meant that the ordinary design approaches could not do anymore. That meant that we had to support our designs by means of full-scale tests.
The investment in full-scale trials is very useful because after a trial, you're sure that the design method is really working.
Well, I think it's great. It looks great. You see already around the stations, the public is using it. I think that although we worked on it for 15 years, of course, that pretty soon Amsterdam can imagine a situation without the North-South line.
It was challenging every day. Every day you have to find solutions for a new upcoming problem. So you need to be careful. It was challenging for us, but challenging for the inhabitants of Amsterdam as well, because it took longer than we thought. So always have to be in communication with the surrounding owners of the building as well.
The challenges were so big that we knew that we had to work together very closely for the best result possible. And I think we did.
The North-South Metro line is now open. Besides giving the Netherlands a leading position in tunnel technology, the whole project is essential for the economic development of the metropolitan region of Amsterdam. Residents and visitors can move around safely and easily, making Amsterdam more accessible now and in the future. TEC, Tunnel Engineering Consultants, making regions future-proof.